सज्जन चलेगा तुम विनती करी तेरी पाप पड़े तोरे कितना मनाया फिर भी नहीं सुनी रे छोड़ के कहाँ चली गिरत रात अंधेरा डरावे लोहित मोहे रुलावे पंछी अकेला सुना है बसेरा वाट तकत तुरे आवन की छोड़ के कहाँ चले
Mahabahu Brahmaputra. This great river, the river that was born in the glacial wombs of the mighty Himalayas, has in its kingdom yet another wonderful state, Sikkim. Sikkim belongs to the Himalayas, as does the Brahmaputra, and is the youngest member of the Northeast family. Sikkim is a tiny state, just a little over 7,000 square kilometers in area. Come, let us go towards the Brahmaputra's tributary, the river Tista.
Are torsha nodir dhare dhare oi didigo manshay nodir dhare didigo manshay nodir dhare aj sonar budhu gaan gaiya jaye didi tor tar ki mor tar
sandwiched between the kingdoms of Bhutan on the east and Nepal on the west Sikkim also shares the border with China and Tibet through which flows the mighty Brahmaputra for over 2800 kilometers before entering India. The journey into the heart of Sikkim and to Gangtok, the capital, is truly enchanting. It's just about 125 kilometers from Siliguri and New Jalpaiguri, the nearest railheads. This dainty little town is elevated about 5,500 feet high. The word Gangtok literally means top of the hill in the local language. Sikkim was, till 1975, a tiny monarchy having states of protectorate of India. In 1975, it became a part of India. Gangtok has a very strong Buddhist presence all over. And several ancient Buddhist monasteries are located in and around town.
Buddham Sharanam Gacchami Dhammam Sharanam Gacchami Sangham Sharanam Gacchami.
That was the Suk Lakhong Monastery. Located within the premises of the old palace, this monastery was actually used during royal functions like weddings and coronations. And this is the Enche Monastery, considered as one of the most important monasteries in Sikkim. This monastery is more than 200 years old and is constructed at a site that was blessed by Lama Drupdob Karpo. Drupdob Karpo was a revered tantric master who was reputed for his powers to fly. This monastery follows the Nyingma order of Buddhism, and the main festival and dance is held on the 12th month of the Tibetan calendar. This intricate artwork are frescoes and murals by nameless artists who themselves were holy men, for whom drawing and painting were also forms of worship. Gangtok also has a wonderful center of Tibetan and Buddhist studies. The foundation stone of this center was laid by the revered Dalai Lama in 1957. This institute is famous the world over for its rich repository of knowledge in the form of books, and research scholars from all over the world come here regularly for studies. There are about 30,000 books here on Tibetology and Buddhism. Most of these books are extremely rare and are not available anywhere else in the world. These are called xylographs. Xylographs are documents that are printed by using wooden slabs that have the matter embossed on them in the reverse. Here are also volumes of translations of the original teachings of the great Lord Buddha. One finds here numerous writings by distinguished Buddhist scholars from different parts of the entire world. There is also a museum attached to this institute. The quaint part of the designs on the wall murals are very similar to the Chinese form of art with dragons. The intricacy of the dragon, the colors, the vibrancy on the walls are very, very oriental. And yet, the musical instrument, the daily use of pots and pans and weapons are so akin to the northeastern neighbors. Here, the great Lord Buddha is so Nepalese in his texture, form, beauty, and expression. So very Indian, not Oriental in the least. The largest and the most famous monastery in Sikkim is the Rumtek Monastery. The Rumtek Monastery is situated at a distance of 24 kilometers from Gangtok, the capital of Sikkim. The present building was constructed in the year 1960 by His Holiness the Gwalior Karmapa. The Gwalior Karmapa was the 16th Karmapa who came to settle here in the late 1950s when China invaded Tibet. With its beautiful traditional architecture, carved and painted woodwork, magnificent murals and treasures of manuscripts and icons, Rumtek is a splendid example of the Tibetan monastic art in Sikkim. These wall paintings, tankas and silk banners are truly wonderful works of art. These paintings look very similar to the Chinese art form, which suggests it has a strong influence of the Mongolian culture. It is now the residence of His Holiness and the headquarters of the Dharma Chakra Religious Center. The monastery also offers employment, education, and medical help. This is the ground floor of the Rumtek Monastery. And this is the main prayer hall. The Rumtek Monastery is an extremely important Buddhist pilgrimage site. And from the top floor over here, where there's a small and beautiful stupa, one can look out and see heaven. Behind the main Rumtek Monastery is the lavishly decorated Karmashri Nalanda Institute of Buddhist Studies. This institute attracts students from the world over. At a little distance is the Hermitage. Monks come here for going into complete seclusion and isolation to carry out spiritual meditation of far longer duration. Sometimes the monks go into periods as long as 3 complete years. This is the original old Rumtek Monastery. This was built in the year 1730 by the 9th Karmapa, but was unfortunately destroyed in a very big fire. But the reconstructed monastery is also equally beautiful. This is the magnificent Kanchenjunga. Om Mawa Kanchanjanga. Such a matter of pride. 28,156 feet tall is the third highest peak in the world. Just watch the Himalayas, the home of our dear old Red River, the mighty Brahmaputra. This road we are currently traveling is Gangtok-Nathula Highway. This is the hallowed oval-shaped glacial Songo Lake. It is at a height of 12,310 feet. Till 1962, caravans of mules and yaks used to ply on this road carrying various items between India and China. We are now driving up to Nathula. Harbhajan Singh, a 19-year-old soldier, died in a fierce battle between China and India several years ago. Did he die? No. He still visits his senior army officers stationed there in their dreams and warns them in advance about impending enemy attacks, and has still devoted himself, even after death, in patriotism to his country. This temple has been constructed there by the local people in devotion to him and worship him as Baba Harbhajan Singh. And the Indian Army worship him by sending him his pay packet, his uniform and call sheet. He serves his country till today. This road we are currently traveling on is the Gangtok-Nathula Highway. This is also actually the old trade route between India and China. This famous path had remained closed over four decades since 1962. 1962 was the war waged between China and India. But today, things have changed with time. There, China, the big brother, watches over us, India, and no longer with trepidation and no longer with suspicion. Let's watch and see, with amazement, what our crew went through. This is the first ever Indian television crew that was allowed to arrive at this peak, which is the exact point of friendship today on the Indo-China border in Sikkim. Today, Big Brother China watches over us, yes, but with affection, warmth, and friendship. We Indians too have reciprocated and welcomed them to our territory. We are brothers today. We don't shake hands. We embrace each other forever.
Pa pade tore kitne